Hey guys, just going to jump in here before the tutorial starts. Now we have some exciting news in the form of a brand new piece of technology coming to you very, very soon. I can't talk about it just yet, but a video is coming to answer all your questions. So be sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified because this one's a game changer. I've taken enough of your time, so over to Jamie.
Hey everybody, welcome back with a new video. My name is Jamie Ludd from the Film Empire YouTube channel, and today I'm going to show you how to export camera data from Blender into HitFilm. For this, we'll be using Blender 2.80 or higher. I'm using 2.82, HitFilm Express or HitFilm Pro, and a nifty little Python script created by Josh. Head over to the GitLab page with a link in the description. Locate io.export.hitfilm.py and click it. Welcome to the Matrix. These few hundred lines of code will transform Blender's camera data into a composite shot HitFilm can work with. Click the download button, and if your computer prompts you to choose whether you want to keep the file, do so. Remember the location of the downloaded file since we'll be using it in a bit. Open up Blender if you haven't already and locate the Preferences tab from the Edit menu. Once there, head over to Add-ons and click the Install button. Now choose the Python script from your download location and make sure it is turned on with the checkbox. I'll now give a quick rundown of keyframing a camera in Blender. Make sure you have a timeline window to work with. It should be there by default, but in case you have deleted it, drag up from the bottom corner of the viewport and choose Timeline. In the keying menu, select which keying set you're working with. This lets Blender know what data to keyframe. For now, I'll choose Location and Rotation and press Add. Press this record button. It works the same as in HitFilm, for it will record a keyframe if you change one or more parameters. Moving a camera works the same as any other object. Press G to move and X, Y, or Z to specify an axis. R allows you to rotate. Move forward in time and adjust the camera to your liking. The standard frame rate of Blender is 24 frames per second, but you can adjust this to match your project in the Scene tab under Dimensions. Further keyframe settings are to be found in Preferences and Animation. If you want to further alter your keyframes, there are a few modifiers you can use. Slide open a new window above the viewport and locate the Graph Editor. Select your camera once more and find the keyframed properties. Click the plus icon on the right side of the graph editor to open up extra settings. Locate the Modifiers tab. Select a property, I'll choose the X location, and choose a modifier, in my case, Noise. You can see that instead of a smooth curve, the path is now a bumpy road between keyframes. By adjusting the modifier settings, you can change scale, strength, the seed, and more. Experimenting is key in jobs like this. Now that our keyframing is done and looking wonderful, we can go ahead and export the camera data. With Josh's script, this is as simple as going to File, Export, and choosing the HitFilm Composite Shot option. Open up HitFilm and import the composite shot like so. Now we have camera data from Blender inside of HitFilm. If I add some text and extrude it a bit, you can see how well this works. If you find Blender tutorials useful, by the way, don't forget to check out the Blender to HitFilm Masterclass, like this video so we can see you want more. So I hope this video was useful to you. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments section below. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to check out the FXhome Instagram page for all kinds of fun stuff, including VFX prompts where you have the chance of winning a $50 Amazon gift card. See you next time. Bye bye.